ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ॐ गणानान्त्वा घनपदिगं हवामहे कविन् कवीनां मुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मनस्पतान् शृण्वन्नो दिभिः सेदसादनं प्रणो देवे सरस्वते वाजिनेवदे दीनामवित्रयवदो गणेशाय नमः सरस्वत्यै नमः श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम् ओम् साईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्वः प्रचोदयात् ओम् जयन्ते मङ्गलकाली भद्रकाली कपालिनी दुर्गा श्यामा शिवदात्री स्वाहा स्वादा नमोऽस्तुते ओम् शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः सैरम लीन सैरम फ्रॉम मलेशिया
Sairam Sharma, Sairam from New Zealand. Thank you, Bhagwan, for allowing Sharma and I to share this most important and meaningful story of Bhagwan. Our topic is the diamond studded medallion, and we welcome our listeners wherever you may be, loving Sairam to all. In 1976, Sathya Sai Baba made a very intriguing announcement to his students. He had just manifested a small metal disc in his hand. And before he materialized this disc, it was quite large, he stated, "What I am going to do in future for this country, India, and for the rest of the world, will now be shown to you on what I am going to materialize." Swami then materialized a medallion, it was quite large, and showed it to the gathering. The medallion was round with a black onyx base. It had a silver map of India with 18 diamonds embedded in it. The map it really showed the whole continent of India, and it had 100 Sanskrit verses inscribed on it. And Swami said, "This has all the information about the avatar." He then said, in Telugu, and I am giving the English translation, "What I have materialized contains the map of India and contains all the 18 different components of India. And in on each component is shown where the memorial stupas, which will represent the work done by me, or the work that is to be done in each of the 18 states of India, is being written and is available in pictorial form on this medallion, which I have just now materialized. And on the medallion is inscribed in Sanskrit the words, the works, and the future tasks which I am going to fulfill. This body in which I have come is going to be present for another 46 years from now onwards. And in those 46 years, whatever dharma sthapana, whatever work will be done by me, is engraved and embedded on this medallion." In fact, dear listeners, Swami's entire speech can be seen if you simply Google Sathya Sai Baba, the divine medallion. And there is even a video audio transcript of Swami speaking and one of the professors translating for him. He also goes on to tell that he gives the entire program for his SSEHV mission, and he states something of great importance. He says that these great pillars will be erected in India, memorial stupas, and they will be erected in certain components of India. What does he mean by components? A component is something that holds something together. In a recipe, for example, the components are the ingredients of the recipe. But Swami is talking about something much more important. The components of India, what are these? These are the most sacred places on the continent, on the subcontinent. And of course, the first pillar has already been erected in the ashram, the lotus pillar, the lotus stupa. Indeed, Swami also mentioned in another discourse that in the future, in the golden age, there will be no more need for temples, churches, cathedrals, synagogues, and such, because it will be all one. The only religion will be of love, and he has stated that there will be pillars erected, similar to the lotus stupa, which celebrate all religions, because all religions lead to the one. As you all know, the pillar in Prashanti Nilayam is topped by a lotus, which is unfolding, and that is our super consciousness and our realization that we are one with the divine. And as Swami pointed out, all religions lead to this realization. Therefore, all should be celebrated as the one. When you think about it, when we have these separate buildings, separate temples, separate churches, even in Christian religion, there are many different divisions, and so different churches are there. There is the Catholic, Lutheran, Methodist, Presbyterian, and so on. And Swami is telling us that in the golden age, there will be no need for all these divisions in religion, because everyone will have realized that it is all one, and the only religion will be the religion of love. And this will be celebrated by the erection of pillars throughout the world, not just in New Zealand, but throughout the world. It's something to think about, something to look forward to, and something to ponder about the current state of the world religions, where still all is separate. Om Shri Sai Ram.
Om Shri Sai Ram. Tasmat karunya bhavena raksha raksha saishwara hari om tat sat shri saishwara arpanamastu. Om shanti 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 hem.